Welcome, Minneapolis Junior Senior High School fans, to Gypsum, Kansas, to the campus of southeast of Saline High School, here for tonight's NCAA League action of Minneapolis being hosted by southeast of Saline, both girls and the boys, as we're well into the second round of league action here in this 2015 season. Dale Leach and Mike Perry here tonight to bring you this game of, first off, the Lady Lions versus southeast of Saline. And these will be two very tough games tonight for the Lions. The girls overall, Minneapolis is 11-4, 6-2 in the league. And southeast of Saline is 12-4 with a 5-3 mark in the league, losing a tough game to Beloit last Tuesday evening.
Oh, we're a game ahead of them in the standings?
For a while. They've lost twice to Beloit, and I think Russell beat them out there. Hey, Russell.
This is a big game.
Yeah, it is. This is the 89th game in a series dating back to 1977. Southeast Saline leads it 48-40 based on them winning the last seven games in a row, Mike. That here at Southeast Saline and Gypsum, they lead by 27-16. The last Minneapolis win was February 8, 2013 at Minneapolis by a score of 32-20. The last win at Southeast was on February 10, 2012, the year previous, in overtime, 58-52. And these girls in high school, I don't know about junior high, but these girls in Minneapolis have not beaten an Erica Montgomery-led basketball team here in their high school careers. At the last seven games in a row, the Trojans have been victorious. And what I remember, right, it usually kind of starts out the same way. We play pretty good in the first quarter, and then they throw on a box of one
in just
the second quarter and shut us down. And
comment on our game earlier this year. We're looking real good at halftime, 17-15 at halftime. In that contest, Lindsay Shute only with 10 points, but Erica Montgomery, as Dale mentioned, senior leader for Southeast, ended up with 16 points. And Delaney White, who I was most impressed with during that game, she had 15 points. So those two senior leaders will carry the load for Southeast. Minneapolis will have to get some good productivity out of Lindsay Shute here tonight. 10 points will not cut it here tonight.
No, it won't. And a lot of it is going to be how well we play against the box of one, because we know Southeast will use it. That or the triangle and two. That's just all there is to it. They will use it. They've used it consistently against these teams, and it's been very effective. And, of course, Erica Montgomery, the 6'1", is a post player for the Trojans, is very effective on the inside, probably averages 15 points a game.
Average sure. Listed at 5'11", but she's at least 6 foot tall.
Yeah.
And you can tell by the box scores back on earlier this year when we played them. Jade Rilott had 13 points, and that's dishing down low because they had Shute covered up on the outside. So it's going to be a big game for Jade Rilott if she can. And Nicole Forte is going to have to come through with more than 5 points.
And did we have anything out of Venere in that game? Seven.
Well, we did.
Yeah,
but
a deuce and a couple free throws.
A girl that's averaging 16 points a ball game is going to have to get her average.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, she will.
Big game tonight here, that's for sure. Dale mentioned we're one up better on them in the standings in the league, and we can take them down here tonight at Southeast. It will be the first time since 2012 that we beat them here, but better yet, Erica Montgomery is going to be tough to beat along with her sidekick, Delaney White.
Sub-state standings, Minneapolis is tied with Beloit for the second seed, both with 11-4 records. TMP of Hayes is first with a 13-2 record. Norton's nipping on the heels with 10-5, Boisington 10-6.
This is girls.
Yes.
Yeah.
Okay. Yep. Well, it is a big game. The girls and the boys.
Now the starting lineups for Minneapolis. And Dale, we can talk about the boys later on, but I'm sure you will. But what a game the other night with TMP and Scott Shetty.
Oh, wow. Yeah.
Four overtime
Four
thriller.
Overtimes.
For Minneapolis, number five, Shay Allison will be starting in the post. And for southeast of Saline, Kylie Poe. For Minneapolis, number 12, the power forward, Jade Rilott. And for southeast of Saline, Erica Montgomery. For Minneapolis, shooting guard, number 22, Lindsay Shoup. And for southeast, number 11, Delaney White. She is a player. She is pesky. Very aggressive all over the floor. For Minneapolis, she'll run the point. That'll be Nicole Forte, number 34. And number 24, southeast of Saline, is Kylie Thaxton.
Thaxton had a pretty good game against us, too. I don't know what she had point-wise, but overall her game was pretty good, I think.
They have Thaxton listed at 5'9", and she's every bit as tall as Erica Montgomery. For Minneapolis, Mackenzie Allison, and for southeast, Allison Stetterheim.
Well, I guess I better stand up.
They are going to have the national anthem?
Doesn't look like it. That'll probably be before the boys' game.
Well, we're just about ready to tip. Dale mentioned one of the bigger games of the year for the girls. It will boost not only the standings, but girls will take this win as a huge step forward in their season. Montgomery and Allison to tip it off. And we're underway. They have the tip. It goes back to Pogue. And right through the hands of Stetterheim, the pass to the left wing. No full court pressure, and Minneapolis will play it in. They turn it over on their first possession. And it's at least a man-to-man on shoot. Dribble drive on the baseline. Mackenzie Allison shot. Oh, my. Off the glass. Should have had that one. That was a easy shot.
Shay Allison with the rebound and couldn't get the putback up. It was blocked.
It will remain with Minneapolis possession as we box up on the inbounds play. Out front it goes to Jade Rilott.
They aren't doing the box and one yet.
Not
it's
really.
Three.
It looks like a 2-3 zone to me, and I have to agree with you, Dale. It's your standard run of the mill. Ball stripped away by Delaney White. As Shay Allison brought it down to the quick hands of White, we turn it over. Stetterheim, right wing, back to White. Entry pass to Caxton. Outside shot by Pogue, and that was a three. Southeast Lady Trojans with an early 3-0 lead. Jade Rilott out on top. They are guarding the 3-point line. Now the entry pass to Allison. This one is up and in. McKenzie gets that one to drop. Now all the way in Pogue. Left hand layup, no good. She's fouled. And I believe it was McKenzie Allison with the reach in. No.
Foul on Minneapolis. Shea Allison.
Shea Allison is whistled with the foul.
Two free throws here.
Two shot foul. First one back, rim no good.
And for Minneapolis, charisma victory at the line for Southeast, Charlie Pogue.
Charisma Vigneri into the contest for Minneapolis. Pogue gets the free throw line. Second throw on its way. It is good.
So Pogue with all 4 points of the Trojans so far.
Just underway here, 4-2 Southeast. Purples have the lead. Entry pass to Shea Allison, turns and shoots, no good. Off the backboard and off the back of the rim, and it rolls out. Southeast.
Montgomery collects the rebound.
Has the rebound. Thaxton. Pogue back to Thaxton. Shot from the outside. Three-pointer all the way over the rim, no good. And Forte has the rebound. Gets it off to Shoup. She stops at the three-point line and shoots. It's good.
And the Lions are up 5-4.
I think this 2-3 zone is going to be short-lived,
yes,
Dale.
No doubt.
Pogue gets it off to Stetterheim, guarded by Charisma Vigneri. Man-to-man defense by Minneapolis. As Shea Allison drops back down for help defense, Pogue has it. Entry pass to Montgomery, turns and shoots. That
oh, it's Traveler.
Should have been a jump ball, actually, but now Shoup. Layup no good. Minneapolis has the rebound. Jade Gerlot, the offensive board. Now Forte all the way in. She is fouled. I can't understand why they didn't call something where she went up and
yeah,
down and traveling. I think you're right. Dale would have been the correct call. Minneapolis did not play the ball. She just lost it on the hip of the defender. Forte's free throw rimming in.
At the line for Minneapolis, Nicole Forte.
6-4 Minneapolis. Make it 7-4. She got them both. The girls can do this, Dale. They
yes,
just
they
have
can.
To play well and not turn it over. Montgomery with the rebound. Her shot no good, and Forte comes out of there with a big, strong defensive rebound. All the way in. Nice dish. Nice dish. Drops it down to the low block, and Shea Allison has it up and in. War the Lady Lions out front. That was
good
a
walk.
Yeah. Good call. And forced error.
9-4 Minneapolis, 4:37 remaining in the quarter.
Coach Wayne Sager for the Southeast Lady Knights. Here comes a little half-court trap. Shoup picks up her dribble, gets it off the lot, and we do just exactly what we need to do to get it over in fine fashion. Forte stops and shoots off the front of the rim, no good. And Long Karam goes out to shoot. Now Chase Allison with another. Keeps that ball above her head. I like that, Dale.
Yep, I do too. You better bring it down, you get in trouble.
Yep. Stetterheim in the backcourt, guarded by Forte. Good double team, now down low. Oh, she had a layup. Now Stetterheim does. Off the glass and
Allison
in.
Stetterheim.
Makes the score 11-6, Minneapolis.
Calhoun had the open avenue. Now we've got trapped. We get out of that, though. Nicely done, but we throw it away as Stetterheim jumps in front of Shea Allison. They've seen that a couple times before. And oh,
it's a Shea Allison tippet, I guess.
No, that, she did not even touch it. She wasn't even close.
I'm just telling you what the call was, Mike.
Yeah, but it was way over the top of everyone. Yeah. Okay.
I don't agree with him. I'll tell you what the call is.
Oh, three-pointer no good. Forte has another big defensive rebound. 11-5, Minneapolis. Shoop from the outside. Back rim no good. Montgomery has the rebound. Pogue. And it's stolen by Shoop. Crossover, yeah, take that left hand all the way in.
Can't get the layup. Vineri with the rebound, but it's tied up.
A jump ball is called with Delaney White. Possession arrow favors Minneapolis. We'll play it in.
There's a light missing up there.
Pardon?
There's a light missing up there on the scoreboard.
What am I missing then?
There is a light missing.
Yes, but what am I missing?
It's a six.
That's a six?
Yes.
Okay. I'm blocked by the pipe on the other one. We throw it away on the inbounds play. Good grief. Pogue off to Montgomery. Here's an easy deuce. Yeah, I get rid of that. No, it's still there. The eight looks like a nine now down there.
Backwards nine.
Shoot. Gets it off to Shea Allison. Up and in. Boy, we can keep that up all night long, Dale. We're going to be in pretty decent shape.
Dish and bounce those balls off the glass, hit through the hoop.
13-8, long shot from the outside. Callahan gets her own rebound. Pogue on the right wing, back to Delaney White. Stetterheim down to Montgomery. She walked before she got the shot off. It would have been a foul. Well, that's a great start for Shea Allison, isn't it, Dale?
It really is. Shea Allison in for
Adlin Laws in for Shea Allison.
Laws in for Allison, and somebody came in for
a little full court pressure. Laws, skip pass to Shoop, and she'll get it over. We've got numbers, 3-on-2, scoop shot, she's fouled.
Mackenzie Allison came in for Lott, I believe.
Shoop to the free throw line, this will be a two-shot foul. And that foul is on Erica Montgomery. Her first, second, third team foul, excuse me. Free throw, no good.
Yeah, 13-8.
I just have two team fouls as well. They had three there for a minute. Free throw, good. One out of two from the charity stripe. Delaney White with the ball. Minneapolis has fallen back into a little bit of a zone here. Stetterheim shot from the outside, no good. Mackenzie Allison runs down the rebound, gets it off to Forte. Forte to Shoop, 2-on-1. And Southeast gets back quickly. Forte takes a shot in traffic, and
that rolled in.
Foul on Minneapolis, Nicole Forte, her first personal foul.
She fouls on the rebound attempt. We've been fairly good boxing out on defensive rebounds.
Yes, so far we have. It's like a 2-3 zone type by Minneapolis matchup. Delaney White out on top. That was a walk.
Yep.
Good call. Kylie Thaxton with the extra step.
Lott comes in for Vineri.
Mackenzie Allison to play it in. Not too much full court pressure, Dale.
It'll come.
2-3 zone by the Purples. Entry pass to Forte. Bounce pass to Mackenzie Allison. They're going to call 3 seconds. No. We get it up and in before they do.
High-low action from Allison to Laws.
Adeline Laws gets it up and in. Stetterheim. Entry pass to Thaxton. Jump shot in and out. No good. And Nicole Forte with another defensive rebound. Forte positioning herself perfectly on that defensive glass. Laws with the ball above her head. Dribble drive around the baseline. Stop, shoots. Way over the rim. No good. And Stetterheim has the rebound on the other side.
That's the shot they gave her, so I'm
glad
she got it.
I think she would have been trapped if she wouldn't have taken that shot. Baxton's shot is up and in. Minneapolis still leading 16-10. are going to trap, though, aren't they, Dale?
Yep.
Shoot, follow in, and the runner drops.
9 seconds.
And she
steals the ball to Forte.
We get it off to Lott.
3 seconds.
He almost walked. Laws did. You don't pass it off to a post as they're running down the floor, typically.
I think she just saw a blue shirt. Points. 7 seconds good. Left. It's Minneapolis 18, Southeast 10. They'll get it on the baseline.
Well, she gave it a pretty good heave. Montgomery's shot comes up just a little bit short. Minneapolis takes a nice 18-10 lead here at the end of the first quarter. We'll be back with the second quarter. This is SalinaPost.com, Eagle Communication, Channel 20.
See American Family Insurance agent Scott Osherman for all of your insurance coverage under one roof. The Scott Osherman Agency in Minneapolis, proudly supporting the Lions.
Eagle Communications, home of ECTV, high-speed internet, 910 KINA, and 99 KG Country, is a proud sponsor of tonight's hometown coverage of Lions Sports. Listen to the Lions Sports on SalinaPost.com.
Your Toro dealer in Minneapolis and Salina is All Seasons Power and Equipment. See Ronnie Robbins and his crew for great pricing and service for both new and used equipment as they back the Minneapolis High School Lions.
Well, we're 18-10 against the 3-2 zone. I expect the box and one to come out here in the second quarter.
Well, you know, Mr. Wayne Sager will change something up on the defensive end. Minneapolis able to put 18 points on the board in the first quarter. And that's a good quarter for us.
It is. We very rarely do that.
And the big player there, Shea Allison, with 3 buckets down on the low block. And she made him count. White with the baseline drive. Stetterheim shot from the outside. No good. And the ball ricocheted off the rim to a distance where White picked it up. Now the entry pass to Thaxton, looking for her buddy Montgomery. Not open. Minneapolis doing a good job with a hand in the passing lane. Stetterheim has shot and missed, and not really willing to take that shot, looks like. Thaxton, good job by Shea. There's a good double team, and the reach-in foul is called on Shea Allison. That was a good double team, though, mm-hmm. But we have to keep the hands off the arm. They're
just
calling them that.
Second,
pretty tight.
Team foul. No, 13 foul. Second personal.
It's one place we're deep, Dale.
Yes.
We have an extra guard and we have a couple extra bigs. Shot from the outside, 3-pointer is good. Kylie Pogue, and that's her second three of this contest. And as you mentioned, here's that three-quarter court trap, almost up and down. Now Lott from the outside, 3-pointer way off. The rebound by Laws is off the top of the glass, no good. And we get a second shot at it there. That's a wonderful thing on an offensive board. Stetterheim looks inside. There's Thaxton. And the ball tipped away nicely by Nicole Forte.
Picked up by Laws.
Still no gimmick type defense, as you will. A lot of people call it junk defense. Shoot all the way in. Dishes it off to Mackenzie Allison. Shot no good, and Laws over the back is the call. It's Minneapolis' fourth team foul. Adeline's first personal foul.
Venera in for Mackenzie Allison.
Callahan back in the contest for the Purples. We could use a little more outside present. Charisma does have a wonderful shot. 2-3 zone by Minneapolis. We have played some man-to-man here tonight. Pogue, entry pass to Thaxton. Good double team by Lott and Laws. We double down on Thaxton on the low block. Now the entry pass to Stetterheim. Front rim, no good. Thaxton has the rebound. She's taller than 5'9", Dave.
Yes, she is.
And there, Forte crashing the boards is whistled with her second personal foul. That's Minneapolis' fifth team foul. 5'10", 5'30 to go. First half, Pogue. Back to Pogue. Now Callahan has it. Thaxton, skip pass to Callahan. Now on the baseline, Setterheim has her shot blocked by Laws.
But they get the ball.
Thaxton on the backside picked it up.
Pogue about lost it on slip.
And the reach-in foul on Laws, and that'll be her second.
And our sixth.
We'll see how deep we are at the post. I shouldn't even have mentioned that.
Yeah. Still got another one to come in, too. But we don't need to put them at the free throw line.
That pass was spot on, and we don't box out.
And they've outscored us 5-0 to start the second.
Baxton has that offensive rebound and stick back. I think that was a full timeout, Dale, wasn't it?
Mm-hmm. Think so. We'll be right back after this word from our sponsors.
The Minneapolis Junior Senior High School Lionbackers are proud to continue their long-term support of the broadcast of these Lions games. Join us as we support student activities and the teachers of MJSHS. Go Lions! We're with you all the way.
City Pharmacy in downtown Minneapolis is proud to support the Lions of Minneapolis High School. Come visit Joe and Amber Wool for your pharmaceutical and home health equipment needs, along with gifts and greeting cards. While you're here, be sure to pick up some free vitamins for all your young Lions. We promote healthy kids and families.
Welcome back to Gibson, Kansas.
Full court pressure.
And southeast of Saline. And here comes a little more pressure. Shoup has it as we clear the timeline. Still a 2-3 zone of sorts. We're going to have to get our designated rebounder into the game. Jader Lott's going to have to take up some of the slack on the layup all the way in. Shoup.
Spot on layup.
I thought an extra step, but I couldn't tell for sure. But that was a wonderful scoop shot as the runner went in. Callahan from the outside, rimming in and out. And Laws has the rebound. Up the floor we go. Lindsay Shoup has it. Forte, Charisma Vigneri. Nicole could step up there and hit that three at the top of the circle. That would bring the defense up. Now we're starting to see a little more action on the defensive end by Southeast. They'll swipe the ball from you if given the opportunity. Shoup all the way in, dumps it down, shot. Oh, we continue to miss those shots. 20-15. Thaxton is bumped. That'll be Forte's third.
Wide open on the backside. All alone. Our seventh team foul that gets just two for the Lions, Shay Allison and the Trojans. McKenzie and Shay Allison come in.
McKenzie about 30 seconds too late would have saved Forte's third personal foul. Free throw, good by Thaxton. She gets the and one.
Draws the Trojans within two, 20-18. An 8-2 run.
Charisma Vigneri. Now they're doing a little 1-3, and they're playing man-to-man on Lindsay Shoup. You better take advantage of getting the ball, huh? Oh, she has it swiped by Pogue. Double team down there as Pogue came from the blind backside. Now inside, Montgomery is fouled.
Got a lot up in the air, and she delivers the foul on the shot. So Montgomery with the opportunity to tie the game here.
Gager's first personal foul. This will be a two-shot foul. Montgomery's free throw, no good.
And for Southeast of Slade, Delaney White.
White back in the contest. Thaxton will get a breather. 2:57 left first half, and Southeast has climbed back into this thing. It's a one-point ball game. It's a 1-3 zone with a man up on Lindsay Shute. She's able to get the ball. Three-pointer on its way. No good. Long rebound comes out. We can't grab hold of it. And Stetterheim picks it up for Southeast. Callahan throws it behind Stetterheim. And forced error. She was going the wrong way. Minneapolis now in possession. 20-19, Jade Rulot. Charisma Vigneri. It'd be a good thing just to run your man-to-man offense with some motion, because if you're waiting for something to happen, it's kind of stagnant right now. Now Shea Allison comes out to get the ball. Stops, shoots over the rim, no good.
Kinsey Allison with the rebound.
At least we had the opportunity. Now Charisma, three-pointer on its way, no good. It's back rim. And Pogue runs down the rebound in the corner for Southeast. White, entry pass to Stetterheim. Front rim, no good, and the rebound comes all the way out. Now shoot, one-on-one. Reverse layup, no good, and Montgomery right there for the rebound. Hogue pulls it back out. Now the entry pass, dump down pass to Montgomery, shot up and in.
They take the lead, 21-20, having outscored us 11-2 here in the second quarter. Familiar pattern, unfortunately. 1:22 to go. Was it a full or 30-second, did you see?
I think it was just a 30-second,
okay,
Dale.
We'll keep it here.
Yep, but you're right. It's kind of the same pattern that we've had about every game with Southeast. We're playing really tough first half. First quarter, we're out in front, and they start getting rolling along, and they tighten up the defense. And they start doing what they do best, get that ball down low to Erica Montgomery, and they do some scoring down low and make the free throws. A pretty good team, but we have the players to beat them.
We've had some good shots. They just have not fallen.
We have missed two or three chippies down low, that's for sure. Missed a couple layups. So, yes, we continue to miss a few of those easy shots down low. Now, Shea has made her share here in the first quarter, but Minneapolis actually, Dale, in foul trouble. Forte with three, Shea Allison with two, and Adeline Laws with two. So, and we're 18 fouls. Southeast is in the 1-1, and we've got a ways to go before we're shooting.
They have just two fouls, and that's a familiar pattern also.
That's, yeah. Stetterheim will pick up Shoup. Skip past a lot. Charisma Vigneri has the ball, hands it off to Jader Lott. Really too much of an offense unless you get the ball into that high post. Shea has came up there a couple times. She got it last time. There she goes. That's what you want to do, is get it to her or McKenzie. And then you can dump it down low, but you can't get it over the top of
Erica Montgomery. Is fronting the offensive player.
Not a good pass. Thaxton. Callahan, three-pointer on his way, no good. And they tip it out. They get a second chance here. Almost. Thaxton walks with the ball as it's tipped back out.
Traveling,
and
that's the call.
Traveling is the call. Good. Kind of even things up with that call. 21-20, Southeast with a one-point lead. Everyone was casually walking up the floor, and McKenzie was looking for someone to throw it into.
Shoop had been having a conversation with Coach.
Jadra, she needs
Five
to be
seconds.
Shooting that.
5 seconds. Somebody shoot the ball.
We do get a shot off, but it's not close. And that's the way the first half will end. Southeast comes back from an 18-10 deficit to take a one-point lead to the locker room. It is 21-20. We'll be back with some point totals and some stats here in just a minute.
11-2 run. Welcome back to our halftime show here between the Lady Lions and the Lady Trojans of Southeast of Saline. We're honored again to have Coach John Darrow with us of the boys. And welcome, Coach.
Thank you,
Darrow. And thanks for joining us. Congratulations on a great win versus Ellsworth. Some revenge payback for the loss back in December at Ellsworth. That was good to see.
Yeah, I thought the kids really started. We played better offensively and defensively, executed some things that we didn't do earlier, and had some kids step up in different ways, offensively and defensively. Our rotations are starting to get a little bit better on the defensive end, which is definitely helping us, and it's just nice to see that.
It really is. I mentioned during the game at Ellsworth, I didn't say it necessarily to be critical of anybody other than just to say that, you know, in the 16 years that I've been doing these games now, that was really the first time that I'd seen an Ellsworth team outclass us in their play. They beat us before. They played some good games, but we just were still learning to gel. And we talked in the past several times that we talked with you about how much growth we've had come together. And there was no Ellsworth outclassing us last Tuesday night. We played very well offensively and defensively, and we got some guys continuing to step up that weren't necessarily producing before on one side or the other, becoming a pretty competitive ball club.
Yeah, I think one of the things that probably helped us the most, if I had to go back to a game, it would be that game, because sometimes when you have played somebody in the past and done okay with them, you know, the kids are like, well, you know, they don't have this, or they might not have that, or, you know, they're this school or whatever. And so that was a big wake-up call for some of our guys. And we actually talked about that before the game, about that game. I told them, I think that when we went down to Ellsworth, you guys were just a little bit more, you know, overconfident than you should have been. Maybe you thought, you know, you're a little bit better than what we thought we were. I said, you got to go in night on, night out. And to a man, everybody's there. They just, you know, look down a little bit and like, yep, Coach, that's we really were. And, you know, having the first year under somebody, and they'd already been under Coach Kuhlman for a year, you know, that's a major advantage because you know what to expect. And I think that was one of the things that it's just taken a little bit of time for us to come together and to – it's like I watched the Southeast game on film, and the stuff that we were doing the first time we played him was like, oh my gosh, I just wanted to, you know, erase the tape and go on. And some of the same things are happening during the Ellsworth game too, you know. So hopefully they're gelling. They're finding out where everybody else is going to be on the court, seeing things a lot better. We're starting – Brandon Wolf is just – he drove in the lane several times, and guys were in the right spot, dish it and layups. And, you know, that's when it's fun to coach and fun to see when your kids are getting better like that.
Yeah. And, you know, the last – couple games, Brandon has been pretty much smothered as far as from the outside. They know he can hit those rainbows, and they just have been bound and determined, both teams, to not let him have the opportunities. And it's very, very rewarding to see him be able to drive the ball, not only dish it for some good points, but to get some nice scoop shots and short shots himself.
Yeah, and that's what's nice about him is, if he has the open three, he'll take it. If he doesn't have that, he doesn't force a lot of those shots. He, you know, gets other teammates involved, because if they're going to put their best defender on him and pull him out, well, somebody else is stepping up. And, you know, we put some wrinkles in the last week or so, you know, to help with that, to get him, you know, a few more opportunities. Because even if he gets open and we get their best defender off of him, you know, they're going to come running at him. And he's really enjoying. His assists have gone up, you know, about in the last 2 weeks, I think his assists have gone up at least half or one a game.
Wow.
So, you know, and that's a big thing because that's two more points. Well, they still have to guard Brandon because if they stop guarding Brandon, he's going to put the ball in the hole. So.
Exactly.
And he's perfectly okay with that, which is a unique combination to have.
Mm-hmm. Yep. Yeah. Well, I've been very impressed. Brandon really started to come on last year, and as a senior this year, he's just been a spot-on player. All right, well, tonight you're facing the number 7 squad in Class 3A here on their home floor. We had a big win in overtime against Beloit last Tuesday on Beloit's home floor.
And they played really well. I watched part of that game, and they did. It was one of those games you just like to watch. I mean, both squads, you know, played hard, and they happened to win it on a three at the end of the game.
Was it?
Because they were down, and they happened to hit a three in the corner. Montgomery kid, number 5. He hit a three at the end, and you know they pose all sorts of matchup problems. They got a big guy inside with Easton Montgomery. He's a stud inside, and their outside game's coming along. I mean, they're kind of like we are, where they're getting play better and better. They aren't relying so much on him because he had 28, and number 5, the other Montgomery kid, had 24. So I mean, they can score too.
Wow,
and,
yeah.
In one overtime, they had 83 points or whatever it is. So. You know, they like to put numbers on the board. Hopefully we can slow that down a little bit tonight.
You bet. Well, a win would just be a super fantastic thing. I'm not expecting it, but I'm hoping for it.
Well, it's like I tell everybody.
As a fan, I'm not expecting it. Because I know it's a monumental task that they have ahead of them. But I'm sure you've got them primed to figure out some way that they think they can come in and win. So I hope those kids and their never-die attitude. I'm not going to count them out.
Yeah, well, it's like I told them, one possession, one quarter at a time. Let's see what happens, and then reboot and see what happens the next quarter. So,
well, John, thank you so much. Good luck tonight.
Well,
Thanks for coming up. We really appreciate it.
Thank you, Dale.
All right. Welcome back as we'll get the headset back on Mike Perry here, and he'll give you some point totals for the girls. Again, the Lady Lions outscored game out and gangbusters in the first quarter going against the 2-3 zone of Southeast and led them 18-10. Nicole Forte got 3 fouls, 2 fouls on Shea Allison, 2 fouls on Adlin Laws, and the Lions got outscored 11-2 in the second quarter. Mike, give us the individual points.
Allison Setterheim for Southeast had 2. Kylie Thaxton had 7. Big first half for Thaxton. Erica Montgomery with 5 and Kylie Pogue with 7 is the scoring for Southeast. For Minneapolis, Adeline Laws off the bench with 2. Mackenzie Allison with 2. Nicole Forte with 2. Shea Allison with 6 big points and Lindsay Shoup with 8. And she scored those 8 before they went to, I'm just going to call it a box and one. That's what people are used to hearing and seeing. But the zone's a little bit different, but it is a man-to-man, and that person is guarding Lindsay Shoup. Minneapolis in foul trouble. Forte on the floor with 3 personal fouls to start the second half, which might be a little bit odd. Possession arrow favors Minneapolis. We're underway. And they're still in a box and one. It's actually a 1-3 zone defense with Delaney White out on top. There's absolutely no one guarding the rest of them. Shea's shot is up and no good. She had a really good look. And the rebound's pulled down by Erica Montgomery. Layup by Montgomery is good.
Forte's a little good battle on the offensive board, but Montgomery's taller and can jump higher.
Now we need a little help defense when Montgomery gets headed to the basket. And that's going to be a turnover. Our post is still not coming up. Came up the first time. Shea had that shot, but they need to continue to come up into that void that's left as White is way out on top, the top of the circle, and the rest of the zone is down on the low block. So there is room at the free throw line, and they need to keep feeding that ball into that void right there. Shoup needs to keep moving. If she should stop anywhere on the floor, this offense is just going to bog down. She needs to keep moving that way. She will get an opening if they can get the ball to her. She is able to get open as Stutterheim can't keep up with her.
That
through the maze of bodies.
That turnover was caused by Pogue going for a pass, and it distracted a lot through the hands it went.
Delaney White with the ball. She's the point guard on this team. Gets a ball screen from Thaxton. All the way down under. They have always had good ball movement, and they rebound right over the top of you, just like that. We don't box out, and that's traveling call, and they turn it over, and forced error by White. Just underway here, 23-20. Montgomery with the only basket. See the opening right in there, Dale?
Yep.
If our high post comes up to the free throw line and you get it to him, Forte fumbles it. Can't get a handle on it. Fumble it over to Shea, and it was tied up. It's going to be possession arrow to Southeast. They play it in. Pogue has it. Stutterheim. Now down low, Thaxton. Shot up and in, and we do foul her.
She's deadly on that backside there.
Yes, 8 points. Shea picks up her third personal foul. Forte with three. Free throw, no good. And
no foul.
She gets the rebound. And then on the backside, Shea gets another foul.
Erica Montgomery with the rebound.
Heads to the free throw line to shoot two. We can't rebound all of a sudden, Dale.
Well, I'm sorry, but we got fouled on the first rebound attempt where they got the ball back, my opinion. No call.
We did get bumped.
But you got to fight through that. You got to get the ball anyway.
Yep. Jade Rilott is I haven't been able to call her name all night long. She's not here tonight. Free throw rimming in.
A 16-2 run now.
We need her to show. We need her rebounding and scoring. Shoop all the way in. The left-hand scoop shot no good, and Montgomery has the rebound for Southeast. Pogue into Montgomery, down to Thaxton. That's easy.
High low. Montgomery to Thaxton.
Some people in foul trouble, and we kind of let them go. We can't go get them. Mackenzie Allison with the ball on the baseline, looking inside, and Charisma would go right into that opening right there.
They foul Mackenzie Allison.
The reach-in foul is whistled.
Foul on Southeast of Sling, Carly Pogue, her first.
On Pogue, that's her first. And we'll play it in under our own basket. Cole Forte to play it in. We box up on the inbounds play. Charisma Vigneri on the backside with the ball. Gets it off to Lindsey Shoup. Forte right wing. Shoup with a long three-pointer, no good.
There's
Thank
a foul
you.
Over the back on Pogue.
As I mentioned, they will go after the rebound.
Foul on Southeast of Slate, Carly Pogue, her second personal foul, team foul number two.
Over the back, Charisma had pretty good position. Out on top it goes on that inbounds play. Shoup has it. Runner off the back of the rim, no good. Shot by Laws is blocked by Thaxton. That's what I mean. She's taller than 5'9".
It just
doesn't make sense. White has the ball out front, Pogue. Callahan is back in the contest. It's Skip pass down low. Thaxton all alone has her shot blocked nicely by Minneapolis. Adeline Laws with some good defense down there. And we pull it down on the defensive board. One and done. That's what we need. 28-20. We have them scratched here in the second half. Forte's bomb from beyond the arc rims off, and Southeast has the rebound. Callahan's pass into Montgomery is tipped nicely by Vignarian, picked up by Minneapolis. Turnover. Gives it right back to Big Blue. Delaney White will be tired tonight, running back and forth in the front end of this zone. Shoop all alone, three-pointer, rimming.